gift that keeps on giving. I'm talking about NBA basketball, and it's brought to you by ESPN on EA Sports. I'm your host, Jalen Rose. The Los Angeles Clippers will soon be tipping off against the Golden State Warriors. Mike Breen and Jeff Van Gundy are ready to call the action.
Welcome to Oracle Arena in Oakland, California. It's a Christmas Day special here on ESPN as we get set for a Pacific Division matchup between the Golden State Warriors and the LA Clippers. Hello again, everyone. Along with Jeff Van Gundy, Mike Breen on hand calling the action tonight. Let's take a look at the starting lineups. All right, as this game gets underway, Jeff, anybody that stands out in your mind that they need to focus on against the Clippers tonight?
I love the tandem of Chris and Cliff Paul. Together, outstanding. Now, Chris Paul as the player, terrific. Great smile, but he's ruthless underneath. What a competitor this guy is at both ends of the floor. Defensively, absolutely disruptive. Offensively, knows how to score and pick his spots, but is best when he's running pick and roll and getting others involved. When he is coming off the pick and roll defensively, you're in a quandary. Do you trap him and get the ball out of his hands because that's where he's at his best, or do you let him try to finish? And I'll tell you this, he keeps improving offensively each and every year.
To Bogut. Three-point attempt. A long-range jumper is off the mark. Layup off the fake. Takes it to the rim.
You want to keep attacking the basket and get layups around the rim. That's how you score consistently.
Curry set to bring it up. And the whistle blows on the reach-in foul. Iguodala throws it down. Hall against Curry. To Green. Griffin jumper. Won't go. Misses his first field goal attempt of the night. Andre Iguodala with the ball in control. For two. Can't get it to fall. Green. To Jordan. Denied by Bogut. Out of bounds. Turnover. Oh, his foot was on the line when he caught it. Out of bounds. It'll be Warriors ball. Stephen Curry with the ball, now bringing it up. Jump shot won't go. Green to Paul. Griffin fires. Curry the rebound. To Iguodala. To the basket and the bucket.
More players have to be able to do this. Finish over the top of shot block.
Paul in possession. Fires away for two. And Chris Paul with the jumper puts it in. Curry to Lee. Tightly guarded, gets off the jump hook, able to knock it down.
That's good defense, better offense, a nice contested two-point shot.
To Green. Griffin fadeaway for two. Curry against Paul. uses the screen beautifully for the shot. Won't go. Green to Paul. Off the screen with the layup. Nice job drawing the foul. It's called against Iguodala. And he'll head to the line with under a minute and a half to go in the first quarter. And he hits the first free throw. Free throw shooting knocks down a pair. To Curry. Entry pass gets it inside. O'Neal. Oh, he got hit, and they call it. Draws the foul, called against Jordan. And he'll head to the line to shoot two.
I love the way the NBA player can contort his body, take contact, and get the ball up to the basket, even when being fouled hard.
Good bounce back, hitting the second free throw. He's one for two. Chris Paul with the ball. Crawford goes to the goal. Misfires.
He's a great shooter, but he could have driven the ball into the paint and made a play for his teammates.
Nice pass. O'Neal, it's good. Pretty assist from Stephen Curry.
You need guys who can make shots under duress and pressure. That was a well-defended possession, but that man stuck it even against the best defense.
Paul with no room to shoot. That's a two. And Chris Paul with 8 points here in the first.
The concentration to be able to shoot through the contested hand, that's a big time shot.
To O'Neal. Strong defense, but he forces the jump hook. They turn it over. First quarter complete. The Warriors up by one. More basketball here on Christmas Day on ESPN after the break. Team able to get much of a control here in the opening period. Some interesting things going on.
Yeah, no separation between the teams right now. Some good plays, some inconsistent plays, but what you see is a great competitive spirit by both sides.
And it's a backcourt violation, so it'll be Clippers ball.
This is just really a poor display of offensive fundamentals. You can't win turning the ball over like this. This is ridiculous.
Gets it in, back in play. And there's a steal. Playing inside out. In the paint. Oh, nice left hand. Beautifully done.
Some people overcomplicate these finishes in the lane. Here he didn't. He did enough to get by the shot blocker and then not too much, to make himself miss.
Gets to the rim, and he draws the foul. And he'll go to the free throw line to shoot.
Last year, the Clippers made a tremendous offseason acquisition with Jamal Crawford. This is the modern-day Vinny the Microwave Johnson. He comes in, he takes absolutely no time to get engaged and involved in the game. Got a unique ability to create his own shot off the dribble, which is very, very important as you go down the stretch of a season and on into the playoffs. His ability to run pick and roll, ability to draw fouls, shoot the range shot, create his own shot, make him a very valuable member of the Los Angeles Clippers.
And goes out of bounds. Out of bounds, ref says it'll be Warriors ball. Ball hits the backboard, but it's out of bounds now. Jordan, under pressure. Jumper off the mark that time.
Trying isn't enough. You've got to close and get there and then finish it off by contesting the shot.
Can't hit from downtown.
And your best players have to play their best to have good chances to win NBA games. When you have a player like this who normally scores big and he is playing this poorly and missing shots he normally makes, very, very difficult to win the game.
It in at the rim. LA brings it into the front court. Crawford. Just gets it off in time as the shot clock's expiring. O'Neal for two, nails it. And Jermaine O'Neal with 7 points.
Give me good offense over good defense any day of the week. Well-defended possession, but better offense.
To Crawford. Ref with the call, fouled by Douglas.
Great effort to take that charge, but just a count late. Didn't have his feet set.
Goes for the three-pointer. Paul shot from downtown, won't go. To Curry. Oh, nice rejection by Jordan. Crawford's turned away. What a block. Up and in.
Sometimes the simplest plays are the hardest ones to execute. Good layup.
To Lee. Crawford the rebound.
Defend, defend, defend. Never give in. Good contest, good closeout. This is the type of defense that they must play.
Puts it home with a slam.
Nice dunk, nice strong finish at the rim.
Curry against Paul. Great look. Puts it through.
I love the way they're not complicating the game. Get the ball near the basket and then finish with strength.
Puts it up from downtown. Paul's off the mark from three-point land. To Iguodala.
Curry to Iguodala.
Lee fires away for two. Draws the contact. Yep, it's a foul called against Griffin. Picks up his first personal. Nope, first free throw won't go. And David Lee with 5 points. Paul for two. Quarter winding down, he just flips it up. And time expires here to end the first half. Chris Paul with 8 points. Back with more Christmas Day basketball here on ESPN after this timeout.
Hey everyone, it's Jalen Rose, and I've got your EA Sports Halftime Report.
The Golden State Warriors.
The Warriors have themselves a narrow lead. It's obvious how these guys score the majority of their points, and that's in the paint. They did a great job of scoring down low. The Warriors have these guys contributing the most points to the scoreboard. Mark Jackson took some time with his team during a first half lead. So check it out with ESPN Wire.
What we gotta do is make sure right now we don't give them life. We take care of the basketball, we get quality looks on the offensive end.
The Los Angeles Clippers.
The Clippers have kept it close on the scoreboard. It's obvious how these guys score the majority of their points, and that's in the paint. They did a great job of scoring down low. The Clippers are getting scoring from the guys you see here. Doc Rivers coaches players through a first half deficit. And here it is with ESPN Wire.
It's about down here right now for us. They're scoring every time. Our defense is absolutely let up. You gotta go get this, you gotta go get it.
Game trash. 3 points field goal.
There was a point in the opening half where I was starting to get confused by all of the 3 points. Now, don't get me wrong, the three could be a great part of any team's game. But if you're missing a lot of threes, why are you forcing the issue? The first half stats tell a bit more of the story.
Player of the half.
Klay Thompson is the right choice for this halftime selection. He made it pretty obvious that he's feeling it here today. And it's looking like that momentum is going to continue into the second half. Make sure you stick around and check it out. And here's a look at his stat line.
Cold.
DeAndre Jordan hasn't had much luck getting into an offensive rhythm. He's been able to get shots up, but more often than not, they just haven't been dropping for him. And here we have a look at the stats. Mike and Jeff are ready to get started, so we send it back to them now.